If your year function is not working in Excel, a couple of reasons why. So the first one here, we've created a year function, we've pointed there. This one means this is not a date. Even though it looks like a perfect date to me, way to test it, highlight it, try and format it. And you'll see, as you click these, if it was a date, that would change. Or if I changed it to a number, that would change. This means that this is not a date, and you need to correct this first. Make sure Excel recognizes it as a date. Another reason is confusing the year and the day. So you can see here, I think this is the 1st of December 2009, and yet the year function is pulling through 2001, 2002, etc. Seen as it's pulled a number, Excel recognizes it's a date, but let's just see what type of date it is. I'm going to go and just make sure I include the full year. And you'll see Excel thinks it's 2001. So it's got confused about where the year was and where the month was. Same thing here, except this one makes more sense. So if I was actually thinking this was the year 2001, 2, 3, 4, then this would be wrong. But you've got the exact same situation. Go formatted as a normal date. And you'll see what it actually thinks is the year, the month, and the day. The last reason, you can see this is a date, but in Excel's terms, this is a number. And when there's a number like this, it's just too big for Excel to handle. So this year function is saying that number's too big. There's too many days in the Excel date time period. So what you first need to do is get this into a valid Excel date so that it shows 1st September 2011, and then do the year function.